Good morning, friends. Now we will go to the further aspects of Unit 6 Mutual Funds. In our lecture series 5, we have started the second part of Unit 6, that is, after completing the mutual funds, we started the depository system. In our previous classes, we have already seen, in the lecture number 4, we have seen what is depository system. And and the need for depository system, advantages of demat account, how to open a demat account, what is demat account meaning, how depository system works. Now in this lecture series we will see the remaining aspects of the depository system. This lecture series for you covers depository system, business partners, working of demat system, activities of DMAT system, benefits of DMAT system. Dear friends, now there is no physical holding of the securities by any investors. Suppose if you buy a share of any company, you cannot have the physical possession of the share certificates in your hand, because from 2018, 1st October, it is made mandatory by the SEBI that any issuing company which issues the shares cannot issue a physical share to anybody. It has to be routed through the depository system. It means that the shares must be held electronically. No person can hold the physical shares in his hand as it was earlier before 1996. The depository system came into existence in India in 1996, where all the companies are informed to issue the share certificates in the form of electronic way. So therefore, every person who wants to purchase the shares or any person who wants to sell the shares has to open compulsorily a demat account with the depository system. There are two depository systems in India, NSDL, National Securities Depository System, and CDSL, Central Depository Limited, Security Depository and Security Limited. There are two organizations. The person who wants to buy or sell the shares must and should register and open a demat account through the depository participants. Depository participants are the brokers who provide the services of buying and selling securities in the stock market to a client, to their clients. So the client or any investor or any person who wants to trade in the stock exchanges should approach the depository participant or the broker, like Share Khan, ICICI broker limited, or Geojit organization, or Reliance organizations who are involved in the broker activity. They should approach this office. They help to open a demat account by getting the form filled from the client and submitting it to the depository system. So depository system issues a particular transaction code or an account number called demat account number to the client through the depository participants. Once the client receives the demat account number, quoting that number, he can transact in the stock exchange through the depository participants. He can sell his securities, he can buy his securities. If he has already the securities in his name, he can submit those share certificates, physical share certificates, to the depository participants. Depository participants will submit it to the depository system and converts that physical shares into electronic systems, and that electronically converted securities are credited in the account of the client by the depository system. And the client holding the securities can sell those securities. If he wants to sell, he can put a sell option with the depository participants. Once the shares are sold, the information is transferred to the depository system. Depository system will debit the amount of the shares which are sold, quantity of the shares which are sold, and that is a settlement will be done by the clearing house. So this is what the procedure we have from 1996. But all the shareholders must and should have a depository account made it mandatory from 2nd October 2018. So now you don't have any physical transactions or physical holding of the shares. Now every shareholder is holding the DEMAT account. In the DEMAT account, the account is the balance is shown electronically, electronic systems only. So this is what the depository system. Now in this lecture series, we will study the depository system, business partners, working of the DEMAT system, activities of DEMAT system, and benefits of DEMAT system. If you see the depository system, it has to work. It has a certain business partners under the DEMAT system, like maybe NSDL or CSDL, are assisted through these three important business partners. One is called as depository participants. A depository participant is an agent of the depository who is authorized to offer depository services to investors. Some of them are financial institutions, some of them are banks, some of them are custodians and stock brokers complying with the requirements prescribed by SEBI. Depositories can be registered as depository participants. They are nothing but the agent middleman. So these depository participants are registered with the depository system and they can act as a depository participant. Participant means this agent or intermediary. These depository participants may be financial institutions, banks, or they can even be the custodians and stockholders. For example, depository participants, State Bank of India, mutual fund organizations, or State Bank of India Share Services Limited is working like a depository participant. It is a bank. The non-financial institutions like ICICI and HDFC, they are also working as the depository participants. They have also registered as a depository participants. Apart from the financial institutions, maybe banks or non-banking financial institutions, there are separate organizations which are working like custodians. Like we have Geojit, Future Group, few Fortune Investors, Share Khan. They are not the financial institutions, but they are exclusively registered as the stock holding companies with the SEBI. So these type of things can act as a depository system. They are the agent middlemen between the client and the DEMAT system, depository system, that is NSDL or CDSL. Now the another party who is more important in this activity of DEMAT account system is issuing companies and their registrars and share transfers agents. For example, issuing company which issues the shares, maybe a public limited company or a private limited company or whatever it is, the issuing company is also involved in the DEMAT account. For example, when the initial public offer comes out from the issuing company for collecting the shares, all that transactions, when it is routed out, when the investors purchase these shares, the sales are happening from the issue of the shares are made, or the shares are sold to the investors by this issuing company through depository system only, because it is the depository system which is issuing the shares electronically in association with the issuing company. The issuing company has to give the details about the sales of the particular client, quoting the investors or the client's account. So it is depository system is going to enter or credit the purchases made by the client in his account through the depository participant. So Now the depository participants will have a contact with the issuing companies, and through that settlement of the shares is made, issuing or sale through the using the depository system. We'll see how it is functioning in subsequent slides, in next slide. Then there is one more called as a clearing corporation or clearing house of the stock exchange. The clearing house is going to settle the transactions. What is settling a transaction? Whenever the purchase and sale happens, the shares are to be transferred from the seller's account to the buyer's account. Seller's name should be transferred to buyer's share, buyer's name when the sale of the security happens. So the change of name happens here. In this case, the settlement has to be made. We call settlement when the name is changed and amount is paid by the buyer to the seller of the shares. So all these activities are done from the clearing house in the stock exchange. Clearing house is a partner in the stock exchange. The stock exchange is going to settle the accounts through clearing agents, clearing corporations or clearing house. Now the clearing house and clearing corporations, when the settlement is done, the depository system is informed about the settlement, and the depository system is going to change the names of the partners, the buyers and sellers, and notify it to the concerned clients through the depository participants. So this is how these three important partners are involved in the activity of the dematerialization system. In the examination, question may be asked, discuss the various parties involved in the DMAT system or depository system activities. Now you need to write DMAT system, that is what you call as a DMAT organization, like NSDL, along with them depository participants, issuing companies and clearing corporations. There are four important parties involved in the DMAT services. Now how dematerial system works? If you see how DMAT system works. See, DMAT system works with a systematic settlement system. Now we have depository organization called NSDL or CDSL here. And we have the clients. We have the client here. Client is the one who either invests the shares or buy the shares or sell the shares. Whosoever is the person, he is the client. Having a DMAT account, he has opened a DMAT account. In between these two, the depository system and the client, there is a person called a broker. See, the broker will give a service of opening the DMAT account to the client, approaching this DMAT organization or what you call as NSDL or CDSL. This is called depository. So informing the depository, he will help to open the client. Client has to place an application to the broker, broker for opening a DMAT account. The client's account is processed and it is informed to the DMAT. DMAT, after receiving the form along with all the client's details like name, address, PAN card number, everything, the account is opened and the DMAT account number is given to the client through this broker. Now, any kind of purchases or sales of the shares happens, the client has to approach the broker, and broker will help to buy or sell the shares to the client. When purchase and share selling happens, it is informed to the depository holders. Now the depository holders, when he receives the request of the purchase order or sale order of the client through the broker, it is sent to the what you call as it will be communicated to the settlement company. So what happens, when the client purchases a share, the broker will process that particular thing through the settlement exchange, the company. Settlement company is in the stock exchange organization. So when the client purchases a share from the broker, because broker has to buy the or sell the shares, when the client purchases the share, the purchased shares are through the exchange company or what we call as issuing company. So the issuing companies send orders and receives the trade confirmation from the company exchange stock from the stock exchange or from the company, and then settlement is made. When the settlement is made, the purchase, if it is settled perfectly, the transaction is clear, then that is intimated to the depository system. Depository system will change the shares from the buyer to the seller, and the information is sent to the DIM broker, and broker in return send that information to the client. So automatically the client's account, when he purchases the shares, will be credited with the shares which are settled. So in this case, the exchange organization, settlement company, broker are all involved in helping the depository system. So depository system is only maintaining the details of the clients who buy and sell the shares and make the transactions in the stock exchange market. So broker is one who is handling all that information transfer system of the client to the depositories and to the exchanges and settlement companies. So this is how the system of depository works. Now, all the shares which are held by the client in his name are electronically held only. They are not in a physical way. No client can hold a physical certificate today. So all the details of the shares held by the client is with the depository system. Whenever he wants to check an account, he can check an account online by just entering his Demat account number. So automatically it tells about the number of shares that he's holding. If the client is having shares in more than one company also, it is mentioned, because under a single Demat account only he is buying and selling the number of shares of the various companies. So therefore, depository system is holding all the details of the client electronically. So that is why it is called as a depository system. It is holding like a bank account. How you hold this bank account? When you hold a bank account, the client is given the passbook. Like that, the client is given the passbook in the form of Demat number, account number. So it is visible in any of the broker's registration number. If you put that Demat account, you will get the details of the shares held by the client. When he wants to sell, he can put a sale option. When he wants to buyer, he can buy the buy option with the broker. Broker will help to buy the shares on behalf of the client from the exchange authorities, or by directly companies if it is IPO. If it is a secondary market, the stock exchange market will be put off option. When the share is available, it is purchased on behalf of the client by the broker, and when the shares are purchased, the purchase information will be transferred to the depository holders. Depository holder in turn send it to the settlement company. When the settlement company of the stock exchange, settlement partner of the stock exchange settles it, when the shares are transferred from the seller to the buyer, that information is registered here, and account is credited with the client who has purchased the share. So like that, this is how the system works. Now, what are the activities of the depository system, like NSDL or CSDL? What activities they do? First one is opening of a depository account. The first activity is it helps to open the deposit Demat account. So Demat account can be opened by the client through the brokers or through the depository participants. The brokers intermediary is called as depository participants. Then once the account is opened, if the client is having the physical shares in his hand, he can submit all that physical shares to the depository system through the broker, and once the shares, physical shares, are received by the depository system, it is dematerialized. The physical or original shares are taken out, and the electronic numbers are entered in the client's account. And the original papers which are received, share certificate which are received, are sent to the companies which have issued the shares, and the physical possession is lost, and the electronic possession is being created by the depository system. This is called dematerialization. Dematerialization in the sense converting the physical shares into electronic share systems. Rematerialization in the sense converting the electronic systems into physical shares. So rematerialization. In case of death of the shareholder, if the shares are to be transferred from his account to other next legal heirs, in that case, rematerialization is made, and again the client who is the next heir, whose account is again credited with the electronic mode, and rematerialization is converted into dematerialization. So rematerialization is converting the electronic mode of shares into physical shares, but it never happens today because there is no rematerialization activity, only dematerialization, because it is made mandatory by the Securities Exchange Board of India that all the shareholders should hold the shares only in the electronic way, not in the physical way. So rematerialization services never arises today. Next one is the settlement of trades in dematerialized securities. Settlement of trade in the sense when the purchase and buying happens, the depository system has to initiate the settlement, and once the transactions are settled, they are recorded in the client's account. And transfer of the shares or transfer, transmission, and transposition, all are done by the depository system. What is transmission? Transmission of the share happens, or the securities happens, when the holder of the shares dies, and they are to be transferred, the shares are to be transferred to next heirs. Shares are considered as an asset, like an asset. After the death of the owner, by the legal inheritance law, the assets are transferred to his next heir, maybe his children, or maybe the relatives, whosoever, who are authorized. So in their name, the shares will be transferred. If the client dies, if the shares are to be transferred to his next legal heirs, this is called transmission. The transmission activity is also made by this depository system, the another activity of the depository system. Now, if the father dies and he has 1,000 shares in his account of Tata company, then the son has to apply for a demat account, and he should give all the papers of his father for legal transfer, legal heir. And once it is received, the depository participant will process it and intimate it to the depository system. Then depository system will transfer the shares of the father to his son's demat account. So this is how we call as transmission. There is one more activity called transposition, that is interchange of the name, not because of the legal heirs, but because of the buying or selling, or if at all you gift the shares to somebody else, like asset, how it is you are giving a gift, like the gold items or any of the assets, how you give a gift, shares can also be given as a gift. If you give a share certificate or any of the investment bonds as a gift, then in case of gift also, there is a change of the name of the person from the person who is giving gift to the name of the person who receives the gift. So in such cases, the person who receives the gift should also open the demat account and get exchanged the gift shares from the gifting person to the receiving person. So in this case also,
the transaction happens, the names will change. So that is being done through the depository system. Pledge and hypothecation services, it refers to the shares can be pledged as the asset. Suppose if you put the gold as a pledge in the bank, you can give the what you call this, you can get the loan. Like that, shares can also be pledged in the bank and a loan can be sought. So in case of the pledges, when it is made, it can be routed through the depository system only, because there is no physical pledging of the shares in the banks. So the banker who takes the pledge and gives the loan should take the pledge of the client. The shares are pledged electronically, where the shares of the clients are transferred to the in the name of the bank which is giving what you call as loans. Here the transfer is not because of the sale, because in case of a pledge, banker cannot sell the securities. He can just hold the securities till the loan amount is received. If the loan amount is not received, then he can claim the right to sell. Once the right to sell is raised because of default of the pledged person, when the time expiry happens, then he can exercise the power of sale. In that case, depository system will record the banker's charge and rights, and then the shares are transferred to the fullest extent from the defaulting pledged person to the banker's name. This is what we call as transaction in pledge, where the depository system takes very much care in this case. All the transfers, whenever it is done under the pledge, there the banker cannot get the right to sell, where the depository system will hold the securities in the name of the bank from the clients. But actually the client is the owner. He can, unless and until the client takes the decision to sell the shares, and cannot be sold by the banker. But if the client makes a default, then the right of sale comes with the banker. So all that legal transactions are routed through depository system. There is one more concept called hypothecation. Hypothecation in the sense, for any of the assets, if you want to give a collateral security, those shares can also be given as a collateral security. For example, if you buy any house or any kinds of what you call as vehicles, vehicles, in such cases, for on the loan basis, if you take that, banker will give the loan facility for buying a house, but as a what you call as a collateral security, the share certificates can be given as a hypothecation. In case if the client makes a default, then the banker can charge on the shares of the client and shares of the loan holders and sell those shares in case of the default. In such cases, the shares are kept in the name of the bank in the hypothecation transaction. Pledge is different, hypothecation is different. In pledge, the loan is taken on the shares only, but in hypothecation, loan is not taken on the shares, but loan is taken on the particular asset that the client purchases, maybe a house or a car or anything else. But only as a collateral security, the shares are given as a hypothecation, as a security for the loan. So this is also routed through DEMAT system, because there is no physical holding of the securities by any shareholders today. So that shareholder can give his shares as a hypothecation to the bank for purchase of any assets. Redemption or repurchase. Redemption refers to when the shares are sold, the shares are redeemed, or if the company buybacks the shares, then shares can be sold to the company itself and redemption can be made, the shares or debentures. Normally, during the life of the time, the companies normally issued companies will not buy the shares back, but only the redemption happens with the debts instruments like bonds and all that. If the redeemable debentures time is expired, which are held in the electronic system by the client, the redemption happens because the company buys those debentures and pays the money to the clients. So in such case of redemption, redemption activities are routed through the DEMAT account. Repurchase refers to when the shares which are sold can be purchased back to the transaction. That is a repurchase system. Then stock lending and borrowing. Lending and borrowing of the stock can also be done for any of these transactions required to clients if they want to lend the shares, borrow the shares, depending on their other business transactions, they can use buy and sell the shares through this demat account only. Then corporate action such as dividend declaration, if at all the dividend is declared on the secure shares and all that, so the dividend declaration will be made through the demat account only. Suppose if at all the bonus shares are issued by the corporations on the existing shares instead of giving the dividend in cash, if the dividend is given in terms of additional shares only, that is what we call as capitalizing the profits. In case of capitalizing the profits, instead of giving the dividend, the clients are given shares only. In such cases, demat account is being used through that activity only, demat account activity only, the corporate actions like bonus shares or any other kinds of issuing of new rights shares and all that will be taken into care. Account freezing, in the sense if at all the shareholder or the client or the customer makes any default in any legal actions and the court freezes all his assets due to any malpractices that he has done, in case of any quarrels or in case of any kinds of financial scandals, when the account freezing happens, then the notification is given to the depository systems by the court to stop the transactions where the client cannot have a right to buy or sell the securities. And in such cases, account is freezed of such kind of candidates by the depository system, like a bank account, how it is freezed if the income tax does not paid or something else. If the income tax can freeze the account of the bank account of the customer, like that the shares account of the customer can be freezed if the customer indulges into any illegal activities and court demands that shares should be freezed. In such cases it will happen. Another one is that service is called nomination. Nomination in the sense if the shareholder wanted to give the name of other person when he dies, the shares should be transferred in that particular nominee's name. In such cases, nominee's name can also be mentioned and registered with the depository system. So in case if the client dies, the shares are automatically transferred to his nominees. Nomination is given only when the client does not want to give the security to his legal heirs as per the inheritance law. Whenever he wanted to give that particular investments to specific person of his liking, then nomination of that person can be registered with the depository system, like how we nominate the bank accounts, nomination for the bank account, like that to the share account also nomination can be made. So now the depository system works like the bank. Banker works for the financial transactions, whereas depository works for the share transactions. That is the basic difference you can understand. Demat of the debt instruments. Even the demat is made for the debt instruments like bonds, mutual funds and all that. Demat is compulsory. Dealing in government securities, if at all you want to buy any government securities to save the income tax, or infrastructure bonds, all that can be bought only through the demat account. So demat account is providing the whole activities of this. That is what the depository systems activities are wide enough in the field of stock markets or share markets, or you can say instruments of the investments. So benefits of depository system, if you see, there are various benefits of a depository system. One is reduced workload and manpower requirements. Because of the depository system, there is no manpower requirement for maintaining the earlier when the physical shares were there, a lot of manpower was required for transfer of this thing. So the paper, a lot of paperwork was required. Now today there is no paperwork. Everything is done online and through the system itself. So therefore, it is more easy. It reduces the human efforts and reduces the paperwork. That is one basic benefit. What you call as advantage of this depository system. Another one is instantaneous transfer of ownerships. Instantly, the owners are transferred easily, quickly from one person to another person because all informations are electronically managed. Computer systems are used for that. So memory is very fast because of that transactions happen very fast. No risk of damaged, lost, forged or duplicate certificates. So when the physical certificates were held, there was a risk of damage, losing it, or forgery or duplication was made by the parties and deceiving can be made. But today it is not possible because of the DMAT system. No impact in case of a sudden increase in the settlement values. No impact in case of sudden increase in settlement volumes. If the settlement volumes are increased, if the purchases of the shares happens more, sales happens more, if there is a sudden increase in the settlement period, so it will not take a lot of time. It will take the same time as the normal course of business because all informations are in the form of electronic way. So easily the volumes of the transactions can be handled. Then instant credit of bonus rights and new issues, IPOs and all that, instantly this can be easily done. Bonus shares, when it has to be issued to the shares shareholders, it can be issued through DMAT account easily by the companies. Rights shares can also be easily issued. Initial public offers can be purchased by the client through deposit system very easily. Then convenience in the pledging of securities, very convenient in pledging because earlier when the shares are to be pledged, it has to routed through a lawyer, through a separate agreement and all kinds of things. But here, no such kind of things are required. Just you have to fill an electronic form with the depository participant. If at all you want to pledge any shares, just give the names of the banks and all that. Automatically pledging is made when the pledge request is routed to the through the depository system to the bank. When the bank accepts, banker will be acting like a pledgee, and the shares which are pledged are called as pledger. The pledger will be given the amount as the loan by the bank. So the settlement is very easy, quick and fast because everything is electronic. These are the basic benefits of the depository system. So now we will stop our discussion here. And we will see the remaining aspects of our depository system in the next class. We will study the NSDL and CSDL functions when they are established and all that in the next class. So prepare well for your examination.